a hot topic for LGUs today. What is it with San Juan? Are face shields still mandatory in San Juan?
Karen, last Sunday, we had the Metro Manila Council meeting and it was agreed upon by all mayors present then that we will, number one, pass a resolution supporting the DALG's call to lift the mandatory use of face shields. And as of yesterday, this resolution has been signed. I'm just not sure if everyone has indeed affixed their signature already, but that is the position of the Metro Manila Council. Submit this resolution to the IATF for their consideration, and I believe it will be discussed on Thursday. So the position of San Juan basically is we will wait until Thursday. And of course, I, as a mayor who signed this resolution, I'm hoping that indeed the IATF will eventually lift the mandatory use of face shields.
Okay, now you've signed a resolution. So just for the record, in San Juan as of today, face shields are still required.
That is correct, Karen. Once the IATF gives the go signal to lift this, then I will issue the necessary executive order, and I will also amend current ordinances which right now penalize people who are not using face shields. So all of these will be done immediately as soon as the IATF gives us the go signal to lift the use of face shields.
Okay, I wanted to ask you, you've heard Manila Mayor Isko Moreno standing by his executive order that in Manila, face shields are not mandatory. And he says that he is protected by the local government law, actually, in terms of mayors having autonomy with their particular jurisdiction. Do you agree with him?
I believe he is correct because the local government code vests upon us this authority. However, it has been the policy of the Metro Manila Council to always act as one, not just in the decision regarding face shields, also regarding the time of curfew before when we were voting for GCQ or MECQ. The Metro Manila Council would always take a common stand. So this was the agreement last Sunday of those mayors who were present, including myself. So I respect the decision of Mayor Isko. Of course, he is the mayor of Manila. He is responsible for his constituents. So I respect his decision. However, if you're asking me about the position of San Juan, we are waiting for the final decision of the IATF. And I believe most other LGUs are doing the same as well.
Okay, but then do you see a conflict here of some kind, given that the Metro Manila mayors signed a resolution supporting the DILG to lift the face shields, and Secretary Harry Roque says your order, in effect, not just Manila, but even Davao is null and void. So there's this confusion now if you're the ordinary commuter. Isipin mo, pupunta ka Manila, di kailangan ng face shield. Biglang may trabaho ko sa San Juan, ay, yung face shield ko nakalimutan ko. You see how this affects the ordinary Filipino.
Yes, tama Karen. Kaya nga mas maganda talaga, isa lang ang policy sa Metro Manila. That's exactly why we implement this one vote here in the National Capital Region. Hindi lamang sa face shields. Ano? Balik tayo doon sa panahon na meron pang curfew. Hindi naman pwedeng iba-ibang curfew ng mga cities. Tandaan na bumabiyahe ang ating mga mamamayan. They may live in San Juan but work in Makati or Taguig or Pasig. So kinakailangan talaga unified, no? Para rin hindi magkaroon ng confusion sa implementation. Tandaan po natin, it's the IATF that makes the policies, pero kami mga mayors po ang nagpapatupad on the ground.
But then legally speaking, do you believe the IATF even has the power over LGUs?
Well, from the start of the pandemic, kami naman po, we adhere to IATF policies. Create po ito ng Pangulo natin sapagkat tayo nasa ilalim ng isang pandemya. We are not under ordinary times, that we are facing a pandemic. So yung guidance ng IATF, ito naman po ang ating sinusunod mula noon hanggang ngayon. And looking at San Juan as an example, modesty aside, no? First city in the country to achieve herd immunity. We also won the Galing Pook Awards for the best COVID-19 response. Lahat ng ginagawa namin, Karen, sa San Juan, base sa mga panuntunan ng IATF. So if you're to ask me, tama ba ang mga pinapagawa ng IATF? Ang sagot ko, tama. Because it's working for us. So I'm not here to question any of their policies. Ang akin lang po, pag merong mga contentious issues, ang Metro Manila Council would always meet. And just like what Mayor Isko Moreno mentioned earlier, tama ho siya, no? Minsan hindi lahat bumoboto for the same policy, but the group will always respect the majority. So kung ano yung nanalong boto, yun po ang pinapatupad ng lahat dito sa Metro Manila.
Okay, now the DOH is also calling on some LGUs to wait for the actual decision regarding the face shield mandate. Some people's concerns are, do you consider face shields as added protection, especially with the crowds going out now with Manila, Metro Manila on alert level 2?
Well, if you ask me again, no, dito sa San Juan, I will always use San Juan as a reference, Karen. No? Yeah. Kasi ayoko magsalita ng broad strokes. We are down to just 60 active cases, and that is from a high number of 1,123 last September 16. That's already a 95% decline in the number of active cases. Again, ano ang mga existing policies? Sinusunod yan dito sa San Juan. And it's working for us. I am not gonna change anything that I feel is working for us. Except the difference now, Karen, ang San Juan, 230% na ng target population namin ang bakunado. The entire Metro Manila, napakataas na rin ng vaccination rate natin. And our cases are going down. So ako, personally, tamang panahon na ito upang i-lift na yung face shields. No, maaring dati, nung napakataas ang bilang ng mga kaso, no, I would have held off my decision on this. But now, since we have a very high vaccination rate in Metro Manila and in San Juan, and of course, the cases are going down, kaya I have voted to support the decision of the DALG and of course, the Metro Manila Council to lift the mandatory use of face shields.
What is your reaction to Health Undersecretary Vergara's statement? She was asked last Monday, and she did say that they are considering, or there is a discussion on the recommendation to use goggles and double face masks in lieu of face shields.
Karen, I have not read any literature yet about this. So let me see what they are proposing. But as far as I'm concerned, if you will remove the mandatory use of face shields, I think this will run counter to the policy. Bakit tayo magsusuot ng goggles or other eye protection materials kung talagang ang ililift ng face shields? Yung policy po na pinirmahan ng Metro Manila Council, we are still asking people to wear face shields in critical areas such as in the hospitals, in quarantine facilities. So, hindi naman yan total. But in areas we feel are low risk already, yun nga ho eh, pwedeng hindi na. Because of the two factors I mentioned kanina, the high vaccination rate of Metro Manila and also the very sharp decline of active cases in the NCR.
Okay, so I'm curious, pagpapasok ako ng mall sa San Juan or sa Green Hill Shopping Center, these are the questions that dapat naka-face shield. Pag nakalimutan ng face shield, there's a policy, you can't let them in.
Wala namang policy na you can't let them in except that under current ordinances, mape-penalize sila. Okay. That is only indoors. No? Remember dati, indoors and outdoors. But then the president lifted yung sa outdoors, so nag-indoors sila. Now, if on Thursday, the IATF will announce that indeed the mandatory use of face shields will be lifted, immediately also on Thursday, I will ask our San Juan City Council to amend current ordinances which penalize non-use of face shields. So ang maiwan na lang doon yung face mask.
Because we have penalty sa inyo, sir, in San Juan pag nakalimutan mo face shield mo.
Ang meron kasi kaming COVID response ordinance, no? So it's 3,000 pesos pag wala tayong face mask, pag walang face shield, and 5,000 pesos for the second offense. So once i-lift yan on Thursday, if and when no, i-lift ng IATF, we will amend the ordinance. So ang penalty para na lang sa non-wearing of face mask, hindi na yung face shields. So I call on everyone to wait just 2 more days. Dalawang araw na lang naman yan. Umaasa po ako bilang mayor ng San Juan and of course all mayors in Metro Manila who signed the resolution, we are hoping that indeed this mandatory use will be lifted by Thursday.
Okay. I asked Mayor Isko also regarding the lifting of plastic barriers in passenger vehicles. This is interesting because Davao City issued an executive order on this. What about San Juan? Are you anywhere near there?
Again, here in Metro Manila, we always vote as one. Iba siguro ang policy po sa Davao because ang difference ng Metro Manila, very porous. No? I mean, there are no real boundaries between San Juan, Mandaluyong, Quezon City, Manila, and people travel from one city to another. In just a few minutes, nando ko na sa kabilang city. Ang Davao City, I've been there a couple of times, napakalaki ho niya, at kaya niyang mag-implement talaga ng sariling policy because hindi naman porous ang area niya. So that's what makes Metro Manila very different. So yung mga ganitong policies which really affect NCR in general, hindi kasi pwedeng ang San Juan may sariling polisiya, ang Manila may sarili, ang Makati may sarili. Mas maganda talaga na pare-parehas. No? Yung 17 LGUs, we are one big metropolis. We are Metro Manila. So dapat talaga one policy, one common stand.
Now, there are more voices actually calling for mandatory vaccinations. Where do you stand on this?
Karen, dito sa San Juan, we achieved 230% vaccination rate simply by educating people, informing them about the benefits. No? Ako, I acted as a vaccine ambassador. Talagang lahat ng pwede kong gawin as a mayor, ginawa ko to encourage our citizens to get vaccinated to the point na nagbigay na kami ng iba't ibang klaseng incentives. Even for the business establishments, we have our vaccine incentive program which gives discounts and privileges to those who can present a vaccine card. I issued Executive Order number 81 also encouraging businesses to have all their employees vaccinated. Dito sa San Juan, binuksan na rin namin ang pagbabakuna para sa kapwa Pilipino, even if you're from other cities or province. Pwede. So never ho kami nag-mandate, never kaming namilit. We simply educated and informed everyone about the truths and facts regarding the vaccine and naging maganda ho ang response ng tao.
Okay, you said it's 230% vaccination, which would mean that you're allowing residents from other cities, other provinces to be vaccinated in San Juan?
Correct. That's correct, Karen. Yun nga, marami nagtatanong bakit 230%. Yeah. We started with our locals and eventually we proceeded with those working here in San Juan, even if they live in other cities. Natapos na namin lahat yan. So ngayon, binuksan ho namin through our One Vax program and we get vaccines from as far as Quezon province. And also up north, no? All the way from Pangasinan. Meron pa nga ako, flew in talaga from Bacolod just to get vaccinated here. So we have opened this up for fellow Filipinos. And that is why the IATF is continuing to supply San Juan with vaccines. Because our facilities are in place, yung manpower namin in place. So ito yung konting tulong namin sa ibang local government units na kung gusto nilang magpabakuna rito, pwedeng-pwede. Dito for the 12 to 17 years old, Karen, by today, tapos na kami with our local 12 to 17 year old minors. Anong next namin? Yung mga nag-aaral naman dito. Those studying in San Juan who are age 12 to 17 will now be next to be vaccinated. This is also in preparation just in case, no? When they announce the resumption of face-to-face classes, gusto namin siyempre yung mga mag-aaral na babalik na talaga sa eskwela dito sa campuses in San Juan, we want them vaccinated also.
Okay, you submitted some schools to the DepEd for pilot classes.
Correct. We have three We have three public schools, Karen. That's San Juan National High School, Pedro Cruz Elementary School, and Cabeanan Elementary School.
Okay.
There will be a meeting today with our City Schools Division Superintendent in the DepEd. So by this afternoon, they will update me as to how we shall proceed with the implementation of face-to-face classes, again here in San Juan.
Okay. Another question is, the DILG recommending that those unvaccinated beneficiaries of 4Ps not be given ayuda or subsidy.
Siguro para sa akin, let me convince them first. Na, mataas na po ang vaccination rate namin sa San Juan. So kung meron sigurong hindi pa nga vaccinated sa 4Ps, allow me to convince them first, to talk to them, to educate and inform them about the vaccines. Ako po, mas gusto ko, personally, if you ask me, mas gusto ko ang ganung approach. And it has worked for us. Kapag maintindihan nila how important these vaccines are for them, for their families, how it will affect their lives. For all you know, they might just change their minds. Again, vaccination for me is something that should be voluntary. Now, to convince people, dapat ipaintindi natin sa kanila, no? Paano ito makakatulong sa kanilang buhay, how it will protect them and their families. I believe that approach that San Juan has been doing has worked for us, and the numbers will indeed justify my statement.
Okay, my last question, I guess, is what is your comment on the varying statements coming out from cabinet officials, Malacanang, regarding this whole face shield situation and other policies in general? Are you seeing a communication issue here?
Well, ako, I believe mas maganda kung aligned talaga, no? Because even us, for us mayors, we will always implement what the national government will mandate on us. Mm-hmm. And if policies will contradict, it will be hard for us to implement. Una-una, mahirap yung kami pa mag-interpret, di ba? It's hard if we will all have to interpret these policies in a different way. Mas maganda yung talagang very clear. That is why ako po, no? If I may share, we have a Viber group with our IATF members and cabinet secretaries, okay. Metro Manila mayors. Ako, masigasig ako nagva-Viber doon, nagtatanong. I always verify ano ba ang tamang implementation nitong policy na to. Inaalam ko muna bago ko ipatupad. Because once you implement something, mahirap yung babawiin mo bigla eh. Diba? Dapat by the time you implement, dire-diretso na yan. So again, with this face shield policy, I hope by Thursday, resolved na nga siya. I have been reading in the news that it will be presented to the IATF on Thursday. Karen, I am hoping that by then, there will be a common stand. Sana wala na nga ang varying opinions. Minsan kasi may mga bagay na nagko-contradict. No? Kaya nga kami nagpupulong as a Metro Manila Council, because sometimes when we see contradicting policies, we raise this to the IATF members. And in fairness sa kanila, pinapag-usapan naman. At saka ito, ramdam ko from the start, Karen, ano? Ang stand ng Metro Manila mayors parating pinapakinggan ng IATF. That is why it's nice working with this batch of mayors na dito ngayon sa Metro Manila, itong 2019 to 2022 batch. Kasi nag-uusap kami, hindi kami nagpapatalbuga, no? Walang kanya-kanyang galaw. It's always as one. And it has worked well for us. And I hope that we can sustain
it. But then it looks like it's not as one with this.
Well, let's see by Thursday. Baka naman by Thursday. Si Mayor Isko, of course, we respect him. Yung decision niya. Siya naman ang mayor ng kanyang lungsod. And of course, I'm sure he's only looking after the best interest of his constituents. And same with all of us. Kami, ang position namin, intay tayo hanggang Thursday. So, to everyone watching now, let's wait for 2 days. We shall know in just 2 days kung talaga bang malilift na nga itong face shield policy. But ang position ng San Juan is yes, sana po ay ilift na.
On that note, San Juan Mayor Francis Zamora, thank you for joining me today, sir. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Karen.